Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Hatter Dolls. I decided to take a little break from the Persona 5 Custom Doll series and dedicate a tribute to a special character. That's right, as the title says, in this video I'll show you how I made Shotaro Kaneda from the anime movie Akira. The movie was released on July 16 in 1988, and this month is her anniversary. And what a better way to pay tribute to her by creating his most iconic character. Kaneda is the main protagonist of the story, both he and the film, they are considered icons today and inspiration for series and other animes. Personally, I have always been attracted by his art design, clothing, and of course, we cannot forget his iconic bike. The same one he uses to do his popular pose as seen in the movie. Even the same pose has been imitated by other shows, such as well-known franchise and recent animes. As with other characters that I have already customized, I made a concept art for Kaneda, but this time I decided to give it a more realistic touch. Before starting creating this channel, the faces of my repaints, I made them a little like this, and they took me a lot more time. However, it feels good to go back to my old style. Before I start, I wanna thank Salt Tank, Jen Dolls, and especially to my gran amiga Artes Danza Maria for having guessed the character in my Instagram story. And without further ado, let's get started! For the base doll, I will use a monster high Deuce Gorgon from the Bujork line. This is the first time that I work with this doll, and I can already imagine fighting with that snake hair. Seriously, this plastic is harder than the one on the head. Just listen when I hit it with something. The most curious thing is that I had no problem removing this piece. But well, just give me a moment to remove this piece from the head and I'll be right back. Alright, as I thought, the head was damaged by removing the snake hair and there are resin plastic parts. Well, I will fix this later. First, I will erase his face with pure acetone. What? Like the tattoo on his arm, but very fast since pure acetone melts the plastic of the body, and now I wipe it with cloth of water. To finally put the head on the body. And ready. Oh, poor boy, it would be best to give a good restoration to that head. And for that, I decided to do the method that Dollightful did in her titanium video, filling the hollow parts with hot glue around the entire area. Staying this way. And reinforcing it with epoxy clay. Next, I will paint what I done with the same skin tone of the doll. This part is always a problem since the color has to be the same. As you can see here, I draw the hairline, but this time in a different way than the doll had. Now I will paint his bald head with black paint. And the doll is ready to work. As always, I already had the wig cut to make Kaneda's hair. Speaking of Akira, I just found this bag with leftover hair wets from the video of Joker. Lucky for me! Now I begin to glue the hair surrounding the entire head as if it were a uzumaki, I mean, a spiral. With the hair already on his head, I will trim it with a pair of scissors so that it does not look like the girl of the ring. And from the girl of the ring to Edna mode. Give me a minute and he's gonna have his original hairstyle. Much better. Then I give him brush strokes of glue and water to stylish and fit his hair. And I didn't even see this coming, Jesucristo! Okay, back to the video, I will be combing his hair as he has it in the movie. Very well, with the hairstyle ready, let's move on to my favorite part, the repaint. With the first layer of Mr. Super Clear, I begin to mark the first lines of the face. As I had mentioned at the beginning of the video, I want Kaneda to have a somewhat realistic face, but also wanted to get some anime touches to the repaint, especially the tracing of the lash line, something I can't resist because I seriously love. Making Asian eyes is always a problem, and for the shape of Kaneda's eyes, I took reference from the Japanese actor Kento Yamazaki, since they see perfect for the character. Now I draw the line of the eyebrows. I want to draw the angry expression for which Kaneda is very well known, drawing slightly thick eyebrows with a line in the middle of them. I will also draw a falling line in the middle of his mouth to give more realistic touches. I will use chalk pastels to play with the lights and shadows of the face. Seriously guys, you have no idea how happy I am to recreate this character. Akira is seriously a masterpiece of anime and pop culture. The scenes of cyberpunk have always been something I like. Have you ever seen the movie, and what is your favorite cyberpunk themed movie? My favorites are Akira, obviously, but also I really like Ghost in the Shell and Gunner from Alita Battle Angel. Well, going back to the video, with the base lines already marked, I already begin to outline the eyelashes with a black pencil, and I try to do it carefully without breaking the tip. To begin to detail the eyes with more colors. Now I will begin to give details with the white pencil. To fill the eyebrows of Kaneda with color. I will give more realism to the face with a little more blush. And with the same white pencil, I will give reflection to the pupils so that in the end the color does not look so flat. In exchange for the last minute, I decided not to draw the patch I made in the concept. Instead, I changed it for a cut in his cheek. Very well, it is time to use the brushes. This time, I decided to wet the brush on the watercolor pencil to paint the white parts of the eyes. I had seen so many artists doing it in their words, especially on JackyOhhh's channel, and let me tell you that the details that she gives on her words, wow, are very incredible. Especially because she draws veins on the face of her dolls. Increíble! Wow! And well, to finish with the face, it is time to use acrylic paints only in the black areas. And painting the brightness of the eyes with white paint. Protecting the work with a layer of Ultraglass varnish on the eyes and lids. And this is how Kaneda's face looks. Seriously, I think this is the best realistic face I have made so far, and it was my first time drawing in this face mold. Wow! Now let's see what it looks like with his hair already attached to his head so we can continue to the next part of the video. For the jacket, I will use this cotton fabric that you see here, and I will cut the pattern that I marked on top of it. I know that Kaneda's jacket is leather, but the truth is that where I live it's impossible to get fabrics like that. Don't worry, later this will change completely, I promise. But for now, I will join the pieces together using the needle and thread below. As you can see in this shot, I add a few snaps so that can be opened and closed easily. And I continue sewing, this time the pants. And we already have all the pieces of his clothes ready. Now, to turn them into leather, I will do it in the following way. Covering the inside with wax paper and painting the outside with red acrylic paint mixed with white glue and water for more flexibility. Now, I will put a plastic bag on top so I can roll my fingers around the entire jacket and that the paint make contact with the bag. Then I remove the back from the jacket, achieving a shiny leather effect. I give you a tip, to achieve this effect you have to leave it to dry for a day with the back on. The same will be repeated in the back. I pass a hair dryer to the pieces to make the process faster, and I begin to do the detail with more paint. For the pants, I made this detail that is on the knees with Craftfoam, reinforcing it with white glue, which I will paint it in dark red. Next, I will draw on the back of his jacket the logo of his motorcycle gang, which is the iconic capsule in the middle with the words "Good for Heal, Bad for Education." Now I will start to paint with fine brushes. Oh, I love the design of this jacket. I really wish I could buy one for myself. Here we have his leather jacket finish. Look at the details, leave me speechless. Like the details of the pants. For the boots, I decided to reuse the ones that came with the doll covering those holes. With a pastel skull and making the same details that they carry so that they merge with the clay. For more security, I will reinforce the edges with super glue. And I will start painting, giving them a base of white, black, brown, and red tones for more realism. For the gloves, I decided to glue a piece of fabric that I used on the clothes over the doll hands and avoiding the paint falling off the joints. Remaining in this way. So that the fabric fuses with the hands, I will pass two layers of glue to each one, giving this result. Painting like this. Off camera, I made his goggles along with his laser weapon, made of the same wood that I used for the weapons of the Phantom Tits. Of course, I couldn't do this character without including his iconic bike. And well, here you have it! Made from scratch, just like the wheels. Oh, and look at this. The handlebar part goes up and down just like in the movie. It can roll, but not at the speed I would have liked it. Whatever, this is not a toy for play races. All the details were painted and worked by hand. Just like the stickers. Even as an extra touch, I painted lights with glow-in-the-dark paint. And yes, they work! Doing this took me practically a month to finish. And if you want to see how I did it, check the separate video that I did of the process. And without further ado, Neo Tokyo's about to explode. Kaneda is ready. I'm very satisfied with myself having achieved a result like this, especially with the bike, as I thought I would not be able to do it. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to see more content like this. You can also follow me on Instagram to see previews of new and upcoming videos. My name is Eric, and I will see you next time. Bye!